David fought a national challenge as a youth. At the age of 17, David killed Goliath. We pray from now henceforth, our youth begin to solve the problem that is confronting this nation nationally in the mighty name of Jesus. They shall not be used as a tools of destruction any longer. From now forth, I will declare in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Daddy, for being so. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
When we are approaching votes and people who are looking for election, we continue to pray for them. After we have won and lost, then the prayer ceases. This is the time that we're supposed to pray for our government and our nation. We can all see in earnest that President Buhari is doing well. That is his ambition, and he's doing well. I confirm and I co-join with Father Mbaka. He said that the president lives well for this country and is doing well. But unfortunately, some of the advisors are marching him down. Today, the Christians and the Muslims alike, as we are gathered, we need to pray for the advisors of the president that God will touch their hearts, even the good work that the president is doing, so that they will give the president the right advisor for the nation, not the selfish one for their personal advertisement.
Our prayer on whom descend blessing from Allah and mercy, and there are the ones that receive guidance. Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter 1, verses 570. My brother and sister, we have received mercy and guidance in the course of our 30 days of prayer and fasting for Nigeria and Mr. President Muhammad Buhari. I tell us today that Allah's blessing shall be with us now and always for this tremendous sacrifice that we have been engaging in. My brother and sister, as we conclude this program, let us pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will extend the peace which Maiduguri is enjoying today to all parts of Borno State. We shall pray that all communities in Borno State shall experience peace, just like in Bauchi, in Taraba, and also in Yobe and in Zamfara State or in River.
Yes, we've been doing this for the past 2 years. The organization, we've been doing it for the past 2 years. And of course, under the organization, we have people with like mind, people that believe that despite the differences in our religion, we can still coexist together as a people. And because of that, we are not fanatics. We are just people who believe that if we are matured in mind, we should be able to come together as a people and pray for our nation. Why? Because in the first instance, before our religion, God created us and put us together in this nation to live as one people. Yes, actually, if you are following the train of event in this nation, when Boko Haram started, it was a different thing altogether. Bombings were everywhere, but thank God, because of prayer of the righteous and people who love God in this nation, you could discover that Boko Haram is not everywhere again as it used to be. That is to tell us that God loves this nation. Apart from that, if not because of God's intervention, by now the ENSA's protests could have divided this nation. IPOs are there, agitating, but because of the mercies of God, I know it's because of the prayers of the righteous that God has kept this nation as one nation.